Today we are going to look at the Pellet Plus in combination with the CR10. We are going to do the first setup and after that do our first print. So let's get started. So today we are going to do the quick start. We are going to switch to the laptop and from there we are going to look at what we need to do. Before we are going to jump into the computer, I made some preparations. I printed this mount and I will be putting a link to the model on the description of the video. I also mounted the counter here and put the PTFE tube here. So that's it. Everything should be prepared and everything can be used now. This connector needs to go here into the pellet and can be only connected in one way. So let's do that. Now, let's jump into the computer and let's have a look what Pellet is saying we need to do. So, there we go, Chroma software. So, first thing it's saying that we should start a new print profile here. So, let's go there. So, it's suggesting to update the firmware. For now, I'm going to do that first. It tells me that I should disconnect the power before doing anything. So, let's disconnect power from the front and connect it by USB. I'm not going to use the included cable because it's too short for my distance here, so I'm going to grab another one. Of course, it doesn't really mind which connector you are using as long as the cable is working with it. So, you put it here at the back side and it has a warning that you should only connect it if there's no power, which we just did. Then we should have connected, so let's see if it's working. It's detected the pellet, so now let's install the latest software. It's going to download it. And now it's flashing the software. Here we have successfully flashed Pellet Plus firmware, so that's perfectly fine. We press OK and we disconnect it from here and now we power it on again. Let's continue. It's now asking what kind of printer you have. And there is the Creality, so let's continue. It's the normal Creality CR10 and I probably don't want to customize anything on here. Telling some information on how the pellet is working, we already know that. It's telling now here to replace the longer tube. I already did this, it's about this tube here, the short one. It's not about the tube from the scroll wheel to the Pellet Plus. Normally the long tube is there, which is this long tube. We don't need it, we need the short one, so we are fine here. So let's continue. Now it's going to calibrate the printer, so let's try that. We are just going to follow the instructions here on the screen. We are going to download this calibration, loading it up in Simplify 3D and are slicing it. We slice it just to the downloads directory and reload it here. Now we can continue to the next. We need to save two files. So the first one is for the printer itself. The second one is for the Pellet Plus. So now it's telling to go to printer calibration and print it and to load two filaments. Two filaments and one clear filament. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm sorry this is not on the video, but yeah, it's a bit hard to record. Now starting up on the Pellet Plus. And it's now telling to load input one with transparent PLA. So let's grab that. The transparent PLA is included within the printer. Now it's asking us to load input two with PLA. So let's go ahead and grab some rolls from here down. So we will be using white and black PLA. It's now warming up to 230 degrees Celsius again. So it's now 200 degrees, so it's probably going to the next step very soon. It's loading up. It's warming up pretty fast. I think it's now loading in filaments. It's telling hold magnet to keep making filaments. Here's the first part. And after that, it is spliced in black. We are going to the next step on Chroma, and it says preheating your printer. And I think I already did. It's probably 185 degrees. Yes, it is. So let's go do the next step. There's now coming some filament out, and this is the clear filament. And the printer says here, load clear filament through and stop once the next color appears. So we need to continue a bit. And as you might notice, it's taking a pretty long time before any color is actually appearing. Instead of doing it by hand, I'm going to move it very carefully from here. There is the first bit of black coming out. So, yeah, great now. Let's continue to the next step. It's now telling us to click enter on the pallet and says confirm loading, yes. Let's remove this and press next on the printer. It's telling us to load the print and start printing. So let's go ahead and do that. Of course, you need to put in the SD card first. I will see you when this calibration print is done. After nearly 30 minutes of printing, the print is done. So let's go to the next step. So it says here, once the print is completed, lock in your value. So press enter when the print is finished. So let's do that on the pallet. It's now setting the loading offset value and the print value. It's now asking for these values. The loading offset is 21458 and the print value is 83721. That's it for calibrating. In the next video, we will be printing something for the first time. So, see you next time. Thanks for watching. So, thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And please like this video. It helps the channel a lot. If you want to watch another video, please click here.